Hello, everyone. This is Dr. Rodney Thomas, and today we're going to talk about an agile supply chain strategy. So what does that mean? What is agility? That's a term I usually hear when people talk about athletes. And in an athletic context, agility refers to the ability to move quickly and easily. And that idea of quick and easy movement translates well into business, especially in supply chain management. An agile supply chain strategy focuses on being responsive and flexible to changing customer needs while simultaneously hedging against supply disruption risks. Or said another way, supply chain agility comes down to quickly responding to changing supply and demand conditions. The concept of supply chain agility builds on Fisher's original work with efficient and responsive supply chain strategies. Those strategies dealt with varying degrees of demand uncertainty. But then Dr. Hao Li proposed that we also need to consider varying degrees of supply uncertainty. If you recall, Professor Li proposed an uncertainty matrix that determines supply chain strategy based on the level of supply and demand uncertainty. For this lesson, we're going to focus on an agile supply chain strategy. This strategy should be used when both supply and demand uncertainty are high. Professor Li suggested that an agile strategy should be combined with the best of risk hedging and responsive approaches, because risk hedging addresses supply uncertainty and responsiveness addresses demand uncertainty. And that's a good place to start, but an agile supply chain strategy involves more than just combining risk hedging with responsiveness. An agile supply chain strategy also involves the intersection of key relationships, sensitivity, processes, information, and flexibility. Let's talk about each of these areas in more detail, starting with relationships. Due to the high level of uncertainty in situations that require agile supply chain strategies, organizations need to form relationships with each other to help manage or reduce supply and demand uncertainty. These valuable relationships require firms to quickly partner with each other in order to communicate, collaborate, and coordinate about supply chain process flows. Agility requires multiple organizations working together to solve problems. It also requires a shared belief that leveraging relationships can create synergies. Managing supply chains under uncertain conditions is incredibly difficult, and it requires all supply chain members to work together towards a common goal of serving the ultimate consumer. Sensitivity is also key in an agile supply chain strategy. When I talk about sensitivity, I'm not referring to personal feelings and emotions. I'm talking about being alert and being able to quickly identify changing market conditions. When there's a great deal of supply or demand uncertainty, it is critical that you are sensitive and identify changes as soon as possible. Without that sensitivity and awareness, you cannot react quickly, and quick reaction is the essence of agility. Supply chain agility can also be enhanced by innovative processes. For example, postponement activities can reduce lead times and increase responsiveness under uncertain demand conditions without increasing costs. Capacity or inventory buffers also enable operations to withstand unpredictable spikes in demand or supply shortages. Increasingly, supply chain partners are relying on high degrees of process integration to share resources and expertise to collectively become more agile. Joint design and product development, integrated manufacturing, and co-managed inventory are examples of highly integrated processes that help facilitate relationships and information exchange between supply chain members in the pursuit of agility. Leveraging information is important in any supply chain, but it's even more important in agile supply chains. Supply chain partners need a high degree of information sharing. This requires them to have a high degree of connectivity and even being virtually integrated. Leveraging information is key to collaborative efforts for relationships and for sharing the market sensing insights in a changing environment. When supply and demand uncertainty are high, one of the best ways to combat this difficult situation is to share information in a timely and accurate format. And finally, flexibility is the essence of agile supply chain strategy. People and processes both need to quickly change and respond to evolving supply and demand conditions. People need to be open to constant change and have an attitude that embraces an uncertain environment. Likewise, processes need to be designed in a way that enables quick modification to meet new demands. So why, as managers, might you choose to use an agile supply chain strategy? Well, the benefits of an agile strategy are pretty straightforward. It is the best approach for managing cost, service, and time trade-offs under uncertain conditions. Or said another way, agility minimizes the adverse effects of simultaneous supply and demand uncertainty. When can or should we use this approach? Professor Lee's matrix tells us an agile strategy is appropriate when demand uncertainty is high and supply uncertainty is high. More specifically, that means that we have innovative demand characteristics where products are difficult to forecast and have highly variable demand patterns and short selling seasons. Innovative items are typically high cost with higher profit margins, but lower sales volumes per SKU. Therefore, these items have higher stockout costs, meaning we lose a lot of margin if they're not available when customers want them. But these items also have higher obsolescence costs, meaning these are really expensive to hold and they go out of style quickly. Professor Lee's uncertainty matrix also tells us that we need to consider supply characteristics. More specifically, an agile strategy is typically used with evolving or uncertain supply bases that are vulnerable to breakdowns or have inconsistent lead times. These sources of supply often have quality problems, reliability issues, extended processing times, capacity issues, and difficulty with change or flexibility. Agile strategy is needed when supply and demand uncertainty are both very high. This is the toughest operating environment I know of. It is not fun to manage here. And to make it worse, an agile strategy is not clear-cut or well-defined. Supply chain strategies have been studied and refined over the years to the point they provide great clarity and guide tactical actions. However, agile strategy continues to evolve. Although uncertain supply and demand characteristics are difficult to manage, this provides great opportunity for bright and innovative supply chain managers to thrive. No one has mastered agile strategy yet. So if you want a challenge, go develop the ultimate guide to agility. Until then, if I were a manager, I would encourage you to get your company out of this quadrant in the matrix as soon as possible. I would encourage you to develop or acquire strategic capabilities that reduce supplier demand uncertainty. This will prompt strategic movement within the matrix and make managing your supply chain much, much easier. If you can get out of an agile supply chain quadrant, costs for your company will drop and service will improve. If, and only if, you find ways to reduce uncertainty and move to another supply chain strategy.